What's going on, my friends? It's Lunar coming at you. Old buddy Lunar Fury. Forgive the voice. I woke up this afternoon and I can't breathe. I don't know. I wasn't around anybody sick or around any sick kids this weekend, so I don't know if it's allergies or what, but I cannot breathe. It's like I got a massive head cold. But here is string theory recap. I know a lot of you that like to watch the streams are probably wondering why I didn't stream. Well, you're about to see. Oblivicons is 115. You know what that means? No 3-star black arachnia. And the previous leaderboard, we were 105, so no 3-star Hungar, and also wasn't able to, Hungar and Snarl were for sale. They were in a mixed bundle this weekend during the leaderboard, but I had no money for gaming, so that's how it happens sometimes. Actually, that's how it seems to always happen during leaderboards. They're always during bill week, or, the weekend before I get paid. They never fall when I have like my spending check. And looks like Scorched Earth let me down. I told some people in this one Earth Wars chat that they were probably going to run away with it, because you know they said the top 20 spenders out of mass and synergy, but they come in second, so that made me look bad, I guess. Running my mouth. Yeah, on to other things. RBW Elite is the head alliance for my buddy Uncle Buck's alliance, and he's in the alliance right under that. So RWB Elite, they come in 16th. I know people from probably all of these alliances, but I'm in so many chats and talk to so many of you. The Russian Brothers are 34th. Stonecutters, the head of my alliance family, 42nd. And then my buddy Joker and Harley, they're and Semper Fi, I think. Actually, I think Joker is. I think Harley's in their second alliance. But Semper Fi come in 47th. Yeah, what do you think about that, Joker? You were going on about how you guys are ahead of Stonecutters all weekend. And they beat you, and so did the brothers. My Russian brothers. Anyways, let's see. My buddy Burbot's in Scourge or Ford. I don't think they all they did was complete the ladder, if I'm not mistaken. And there's okay. There we go. 100th. The 100th spot is 630,000 points. 884. Yeah, that's just insane. That means every one of you people in the top 100, your alliance at least had like 3 to 5 people really spending to push you, because those scores aren't possible without coins and spending. Unless the rumor I heard about cyber coins is true, but we're not getting into that. Friday night, we pushed up into 96th, I believe. And my buddy Uncle Buck's alliance was not too far behind us. Maybe like 15 spots behind us. And everybody was like separated by hundreds of points. Well, I worked Friday night, but I was sitting there grinding as I could. And by the time I got off, we had fallen into, I think, 114th. And I was like, guys, we're gonna have to buy, some of us are gonna have to buy some bundles to if we wanna stay in there. And we every no, everybody decided not to. And I don't blame them. And you'll see my score here. After that, I had some battery issues with my phone. Plus, I just didn't really care about the leaderboard after that point. Like I wasn't gonna kill myself to if I wasn't chasing the bot. And I just, I would get on like as I could. I didn't go out of my way. And we managed to get in that, the tier right under the 3-star. So, I mean, that's pretty good because hopefully some of us will pull a 4-star out of the premiums. There we are. 550. Now that 550.831, I believe that was a 6th place score on the Death Source leaderboard, if I remember right. So I mean, that's just flipping ridiculous. Why are you guys spending so much on a leaderboard for a 3-star bot? Because realistically, there's only like a handful of alliances, probably in that 6 to 10 range, that could even have a chance at competing with those top 5 with spin. So, I mean, I don't understand why you guys are like throwing your money at them for these 3-star bots. It doesn't make any sense to me. But, if that's what you want to do, there's, I have nothing against it. I think I might have passed my buddy Bucks. Alliance. Oh no, there it is. There's my buddy Bucks alliance. And when he's in RWB Alpha 510, I mean, look at that. He's never had a 3-star bot. I think his first big leaderboard was when these leaderboards started going crazy, which was Beast Wars, Megatron, and Optimus Primal. And he had a theory, and I think he might be right. It's because all you 20s kids, they're the bots that you grew up with. So you're spinning for them. And then everybody loves Dinobots. And Dinobots have been just about every leaderboard that hasn't been a Beast Wars bot. And I believe that could be true. That makes sense. But man, it's a little crazy, I think. There's a Lunar body, 151. That's where my buddy Dirty Spot's at. I believe he is probably one of my only friends I have in there besides my buddy Deadpool, because I don't know, some weird things went on there. Weird things. What really surprised me is that the DJD is in 167th. They must have really got hit hard by this scorched earth thing. I did not realize that. I know people on Dark Side posting that. And then there's Pancakes. I know people there. I'm pretty sure I know people in Brazil Wars, but not 100%. I've heard Outlaw Predacons, but I don't remember how. Maybe that was the Alliance. I think that was the Alliance Sick and Twisted used to be in before they made Sick and Twisted Gaming Alliance. There's a reason why I'm still going down, guys. You're probably like, what's he doing? Allspark Warriors, I believe those are my friends. I have some Allspark friends that are they're calling, so I believe that's them there. Shout out to them. There's Dutch That. One of my viewers is in Dutch That. That's cool. Or are they in Dutch This? The car, I don't know. Well, there's Russian Brothers too, which is probably where I would have ended up if I would have stayed with the Russians. Because they. I don't know. There was some weird communication things going on there. I only got to do the lockdown leaderboard with the main group. And I killed it, so I don't understand why. And then get to do the reflector with him. That's all under water under the bridge. There was one of the Zild alliances. There was another one. Another mass one. Sesame Street. Well, I guess I know how to get to Sesame Street. They're right above Perfecticons. Yep. That's the alliance that I had been chilling with after my first leaderboard with the right, or with Stonecutters, because I can't do the Cybertron boards. So I went down to Perfecticons, and that was before we brought the Oblivicons alliance families into our family. And Oblivicons was a top 80 alliance, but so you got to spend now apparently to get into that, and we didn't, none of us wanted to. So, and like I said, I cannot blame them at all. But man, you guys should have seen the Perfecticons scores. Man, they killed it. They really did. Like, a lot of them had upwards of 20K, like the top end. And they were just killing it. I was really impressed with my buddies there. There's the reward tiers. I'll never see a 4-star on a leaderboard because I'll never pay that amount of money that it takes to be in the top 5. I think that's insanity. But more power to you if you do that. There's nothing, I don't have anything against you. It's just, I wouldn't do it. We got the 101, the 200 prize. And like I said, we were 115. 7 premiums, 3,000 spark. I'm going to hold my premiums until Thursday because Predaking drops and Volcanicus drops. And more than likely, I'll get some Predacon dupes. So I'm going to save it so I get some Predaking spark, because I already have all my 3-stars. So I will have a Predaking on Thursday. If everything is still on, I'll also have a preview video probably Wednesday, because I believe they were going to let me do a preview on Predaking on my test account. So, you know, stay tuned. We'll find out. They may not be able to now. They may have other plans. But we shall see. And here is our points. Frumgar and Destroyout killed it, man. They really did. So did Magic Doll and C01 Dick and Rage Jaeger and Platt, all these guys killed it. They all killed it. But Saturday morning when they were like, no, we're not, don't spend, none of us are going to spend, because I was trying to figure out a way to get a little bit of extra cash for a fuel bundle myself. I was like, well then, so we're not going for it now, then I'm not taking it serious. And like I said, I just hopped on and ran my teams as I could. You know, I didn't kill myself, making sure I ran every fuel cycle. And I ended at 10,097, so that's okay. There you have it, my friends. That was String Theory. Hope you enjoyed the story seeds and the preview videos and everything from right before and during. Sorry to stream. I just didn't play it a lot, and I wasn't taking it serious, so I didn't think you guys would want to watch me just screwing about on there. I don't know if I was wrong about that, let me know, and I'll try to stream even when I'm not being serious, if you guys are interested in watching that. As always, stay classy, be good to one another, remember, new Combiners Thursday, the 21st. Predaking and Volcanicus. Stay tuned. I may be getting to do a Predaking preview before they drop Thursday. You be busted. Pshh.